It started out as a job and a way of earning money. It turned into an 80-hour a week hobby.
Well, fish and chips is the original fast food, really, isn't it?
Well, I'm 70, and I've been eating fish and chips since I was two or three.
I think it's good, honest food.
It's the oldest tradition in Britain. Fish and chips, it's an icon of Britain.
It needs to be sold and sung out there that it's a great meal for everybody.
It's thanks to the good fish and chip shops that today it's still loved.
I live in France. But every Thursday when I come across,
she comes as well here.
And fish and chips has come a long, long way to where my time in the 40s and 50s to where we are now.
I mean, once you get involved with fish and chips, you can't get out of it.
What makes a great fish and chips is well-sourced produce, whether it be our potatoes, where we sample at least four different varieties a week so that we can stay at least two or three weeks ahead of the game in that respect.
You need sustainably caught fish, and that's not just for the product that comes out, but also for the future generations going forward.
If you haven't got a good beef product, you're not going to have a good end product. So you've got to start at the basics.
And good staff. Very good staff.
You also need a good fryer, and that's why we've got Sid cooking fish and chips.
We have taken each product and we have worked and worked to perfect it, and even when we think we've got there, we're still tweaking it.
The Fish and Chip Awards were established to reward individual excellence, to create a platform for generating publicity for the wider fish and chip industry, and importantly to raise standards, to produce a benchmark for other businesses to aspire to. We have over 11,000 fish and chip shops in the United Kingdom, everything from small village shops, only open maybe a couple of hours, through to larger city shops, through to small chains.
Fish and Chip Awards is a fantastic thing to be involved in, isn't it? I mean, imagine getting through to the top 10 in the country. For the family and myself, I'm proud as punch.
If you come today and says to me, I won my lottery, £1 million, to be honest with you, I'm not be that happy who I came on the first 10 on the competition.
My little sister was born 10 years ago and he wasn't that happy.
Not only have we benefited from the competition, but the whole village has benefited. It's fantastic.
It's motivation for our team, it's motivation for us. Yeah. It really gives us something to go at, doesn't it? Right.
In a nutshell, we love the Fish and Chip Awards, honestly.
Yeah, yeah, we do.
We look forward to it every year.
Yeah. With me coming second in Young Fish Fryer last year, Andy and Lisa, who are two apprenticeships at the moment, they both become semi-finalists this year in the competition as well. So it's nice to be able to offer the chance to enter awards to the staff as well, and give them something to go for on a personal level, to not only give the shop some good recognition, but some for themselves as well.
The competition is marvellous. It sets a standard that everybody wants to be working at.
A lot of people see fish and chips as an old-fashioned meal, but now I think in the last couple of years especially, it's become so popular. People are having it at their weddings and parties, and it's just become a really cool thing to have.
You've got to be involved in it. You've got to have your heart and soul in it. You've got to come in the morning, keep your shop clean, yeah? Get the family involved, get your staff involved. It's a big thing. It's a, you know, everyone, it's just the way it is. It's got to be like that.
Foremost in the consumer's eyes is obviously the product itself, fish and chips. So that is a very important part of the judging process.
A good fish and chips to me, it has to be well fried. Crispy batter, nice white meat, chips that look good and can be tested for 10 minutes without suddenly collapsing in the box. And that I can eat every morsel and enjoy it and then wonder, did I eat that? It's free to enter, anybody can enter, and we get a lot of people in the first round.
We look at the responsible sourcing of products, how they are stored, prepared, cooked. We look at how staff perform, we look at practices and techniques, we look at levels of customer service, we look at how a business promotes and markets itself, we look at how it informs and educates their customers. A wide range of criteria, in excess probably of about 300 different criteria that comprise a judging process.
And then we whittle them down in stages until we get the final two per area, so 20 shops in the UK. And then people like me and my co-assessors around the country are sent in to judge each region, the best two shops, to declare the winner for the area with regards to finding in London.
To enter the competition, you start off with sending a portfolio of things that you do, and then that goes and gets judged to get you into, I think, top five, is it regionally?
I think it's top five regionally, yeah, which the regions are split into two halves.
The next stage is even harder because there's telephone interviews, you get mystery judges come into the shop, so you never know, you're always on your toes.
Depends. That's always scary, isn't
it? Yeah, it depends if the mystery shopper enjoys the service, enjoys the food, and if that goes well, we progress into the next round.
Again, another mystery shop. Then this time they came back in and done a full audit of the shop, going through everything you put on your paper entry just to check everything's correct and you're doing everything you say you do.
Depending on that, obviously, you either get to the final or not. And fortunately for us this year, we managed to get into the final.
Yeah,
and fish fingers crossed, we might win it.
That was tacky.
When we had the phone call to say that we had won, Nikki Hawkins phoned us and she said, have you got your passport ready?
That trip to Norway is an incredible experience and it is something that really is a prize in itself.
Yeah, it really makes you appreciate the hard work that goes into catching your fish for you as well. And yeah, you can pass that message on to your customers, which is great.
The responsible sourcing of seafood has become of prime importance in this present day. Shops should be taking great care and attention and establishing relationships with their suppliers, tracing their product right back to the point of origin. Customers themselves are becoming increasingly interested in where our food comes from.
I think people do care about where their food comes from these days. I think people are more interested on where things are fished from and who did it and how it gets to them.
Everybody remembers the cod wars. I mean, I remember the cod wars when I was growing up, so people are aware of what's going on in the world, not just with fish, but everything. So they like to know that they're doing a bit, and they like to know also that, you know, when they're buying fish and chips, that it is from a sustainable source.
Sustainability is all about the future and making sure that our kids will have fresh fish into the future. And of course, it's very important and it's essential that people are educated and understand how the quotas work and what they're there for.
The reason for conserving fish is to make sure the stocks survive and that there will be a food source for the population. And if we can link the education from the conservation through to the selling of the fish and then to the restaurants, that's something that we're aiming for.
Sustainability is at the forefront of our business. It is the core for our future. Part of that is engaging with fishery scientists to ensure that the scientists have the best data available to them, and that our skippers have the best access to the fishery scientists and generate data for the future upon which both of our futures are dependent.
To start with, people were confused that we were giving them information, but now we have a lot of people coming in, which trawler is the fish from today?
Today, it's become a bit of a talking point.
Yeah,
that's
absolutely.
Right. Yes.
It's the future of fish and chips. It kind of keeps us all in a position where we know that if the fish is sustainable, we can move forward with confidence and know that we'll be here for years to come.
It's got to be sustainable. We're all sustainable. You know, we're only here for a short time on the planet. So, you know, we want to give a nice thing to our kids and all the rest of it. And this business is a family business. It's going to be passed down to generations. And I want my kids to know the importance and the customers to know the importance of where everything comes from.
The fish is frozen at sea. It's all MSC certified. We've just gone in for MSC certification as well, ourselves. So we're looking forward to getting that coming through now.
The reasons we bother with MSC is that it's important to us that fish and chips isn't just a today and tomorrow thing. It's important that my grandkids can enjoy fish and chips. Even if they don't love it as much as me, I'm sure they'll love eating it as much as me. And I want to know that in 50, 60 years' time, that fish and chips is going to be around.
Fish and chips being the national favourite dish in Britain, we like to make sure that it's going to be sustainable and be there for years to come, and not just another wee fish story that they tell out in the boats about, oh, remember the days when we could have fish and chips.
Sustainable fish means we're not taking all the fish out to sea, we leave some in.
People think fish and chips is just a case of doing this and doing that. No, you've got to make sure everything's right, you've got all your ingredients, you've got top quality potatoes. I mean, it's not just about the fish.
So you always use Cambridgeshire or Lincolnshire potatoes. Well, renowned for being the best fried potatoes in the country.
We tend to stick to certain varieties, Maris Pipers, Victoria, Agria.
It's important to us that we use local produce where we can. Luckily for us, we're in Lincolnshire, so our potatoes are all Lincolnshire grown potatoes.
Not only that, we had our fish and chips nutritionally analysed by a food laboratory, and for one portion it's only coming in at 490 calories, which is really not bad considering that some people's perceptions of fish and chips is that it's much more fattening. So I think overall that's why fish and chips is just the nation's favourite.
What does it mean to me to get this far in a fish and chip shop of the year competition? Well, what can I say? I would love to win it. I love fish and chips, it's my passion, it's the family's passion. You know, every time I've entered it, I've done my best to get where we are. And I believe that Broughton Fish and Chips is going to be a winner this year.
It's brilliant. Like I say, we've surpassed everything that we wanted to do at the moment. To get down to London to the finals, it's something we've dreamed of.
We became runner-up last year, and for our first time being in the awards, we were disappointed not to win, but we were ecstatic to come second as well at the same time. And it just gave us this drive to go that final mile and say, let's go for number one this year.
We would love to win it. It would mean a lot to us and to our team, to be honest.
Yeah, of course.
Because without our team, we cannot do it ourselves.
You mean everything for our whole family,
It's not just us, it's for everybody who's involved in it, isn't it? Our staff are really passionate about it, but for me, my mum and dad, and your brothers and sisters as well, I think so. They would be so excited. It would just be incredible.
Feels an impossible task.
Yeah.
However, winning fish and chip shop of the year from Northern Ireland also felt an impossible task. So who knows? We're going to give it our best shot.
It'd mean everything to Harbourside to end up winning this award. I can't really put into words. It's not necessarily so much for Harbourside, but for Plymouth as well.
The good thing about it is the fact that we're all 10 shops have the philosophy of moving fish and chips forward. Everyone with a different spin, everyone with a slightly different concept, but fundamentally we all want fish and chips to progress and to be, get its foothold back in Britain again. To the other 9, watch out.
Got to fight to win.
I wish you all the luck. We've all done amazing to get this far.
Watch out.
Yeah, we're coming for you.
If you beat us, I want to come down and try your fish and chips because they must be bloody good.
We'd like to say good luck to the other 9, but at the same time, watch your backs because we'll be coming for you.
You ain't got a chance, none of you. Sid, if you're watching, Sid, you don't own my shop. I own you. Phil, you're not getting anywhere. Grania, you're a lovely lady. Dave, come on, you know. That chick in Shetland, say, hey, come on, this is the place to be.
To the other 9, before we went to the Norway trip, I actually felt, there was going to be some form of a competitive feel. But the camaraderie that we all felt when we were put in a little bit of a tricky position over there was fantastic, and it made us all feel like one. And that's how fish and chips should be. Fish and chips should be as one.